and the lamps and the cradle and the silver spoon. Yeah. Vikings are looking to improve the offensive line this offseason, and we're just grasping. We're throwing out suggestions. We're trying to help. Like, hey, Ricky boy, pretty Ricky, or George General Payton. Yeah, we know that you watch the channel. So focus right here. We got a couple more suggestions, right? Trade for Chargers backup guard Forrest Lamp. I love Lamp. I love him. All right, so let's talk about the man from Western Kentucky today. So 26 years old, 6'4", 310 pounds, former two-star recruit coming out of Venice, Florida, committed to Western Kentucky. And this is a guy that I absolutely loved and adored in the draft in 2017. We'll get to that. Started 51 games. For the Hilltoppers, all at left tackle, crushed the Senior Bowl practice, got injured, didn't actually play in the game, even though, as we've seen from Christian Ponder, the game doesn't matter, the week of practice does. So there was concern about him stepping up in level of competition, but he came in, they kicked him in a guard for most of the week, and then he just was flush with talent. Stud. Great anchor, great play strength, absolutely destroyed the combine, by the way, just an absolute physical freak in the 40, broad jump agility drills, as well as a bench. It was like, oh, he's got short arms. No, whatever, just kick him inside the guard. It's fine. End up going just ahead of the Vikings, pick 38 to the Chargers, three spots before the Vikings trade up for Dalvin Cook. And again, I fully admit, I love this dude in 2017. I wanted him so freaking bad because remember, that was the year the Vikings didn't have a first-round pick because of the Sam Bradford trade. So the Vikings were sitting in the middle of the second round. I'm just like, all right, Forrest Lamp, he could be there. He's going to be there. He's going to be my guy. Ironically, I also had a crush on Dan Feeney, who ended up being their third-round pick that year coming out of Indiana. But yeah, I just love Forrest Lamp's skill. I thought that he would be perfect in what the Vikings wanted to do up front, and I still think so too. Because here's what happens. Like, you know how you, I, Draft Twitter, you know, Draft Knicks, etc. Like, we remember guys that we loved in the draft, and we'll still advocate them a couple years down the road. Like, say it didn't work out with a team for whatever reasons, and they're like, ah, come on, right? So NFL teams, same way. Like their scouting departments make files on, make dossiers on every single draft pick, and then those files don't go away, especially if they really loved a player. They get kicked over to the bro scouting department. They take a look. It's like, well, it didn't work out here because of injuries or whatever, or scheme or coaching or blah, blah, blah. And then often, you know, players who say Spielman like in the draft, they'll get a second look. And sometimes they'll be brought in as a free agent. You've seen that a number of times before with the Vikings. And with Lamp, it just has not worked out. He tore his ACL in camp as a rookie in 2017. And over the past 2 years, he's only played 174 offensive snaps for the Chargers, starting two games at left guard last season, giving up 10 total pressures and zero sacks. So we got that going on for him. 2019 season ended with a broken fibula, which, you know, can you say that the guy's injury prone? So he tore his ACL in 2017. He had a procedure, cleaned it up in the 2018 offseason. And then 2019, it broke his fibula. I don't think you can say that broken bones are, that he's prone to that. I mean, that stuff just happens. Unless you're Aaron Rodgers with hollow bones, calcium, son. Yeah, whatever. So I'm not in that Forrest Lamp is necessarily injury prone, didn't really have that label coming out of Western Kentucky. So I think he's just mainly gotten a crap roll of the dice his first 3 years and could really benefit from a change of scenery. Because I think the Chargers are done with him. You know, second round pick coming in. He's heading into a contract year. 2017 third round pick Dan Feeney, that we mentioned before. He's already established himself as a starter at left guard. And then they trade for Trey Turner, who's starting at right guard. And even before they traded for Turner, he wasn't starting because Michael Schofield was starting in front of him. So it's just like, yeah, I think they're over Lamp. I don't think that they love Lamp anymore. So they're done. So why not be like, hey, Chargers. Hey, Chargers, right here. We got something for you. Hey, buddies. So you know that guy who's going to be a backup and may not even make the team? You may cut him in camp this year. How about a fifth-round pick or even like a sixth-round pick? I wouldn't even be mad with a fifth-round pick since the Vikings have an extra one from the Ravens. And the Vikings have wasted fifth-round picks before. Y'all remember Corey Vedvik? Yeah, and also, ironically, Daniel Carlson was a fifth-round pick. Great. But I think just throwing that out there, maybe the Chargers go for it. Maybe they don't. And hell, if the Chargers cut him, just pick him up off of waivers. It'd be great, too. Because even though Lamp has had all the health issues, I'm still willing to take a flyer on him. Actually, take that back. I don't want to play the waivers game because the Vikings are still relatively low. They're 25th in waivers before it resets this year. So I would be fine giving up a late day three draft pick. I would, because he's an extremely talented kid. I think he would thrive in the zone blocking scheme. Attributes are absolutely off the chart, and it's just, he's had some really bad injury luck. I don't think it'll be a recurring issue. But also, if it is a recurring issue, who cares? Then you're out a fifth or a sixth round pick. I mean, they literally do grow on trees, according to Rick Spielman. So you have a chance to bring in a guy that is low risk, that is extremely high reward. And if the Vikings are fully committed to fielding the best offensive line possible this year, you do have to take chances like that. Like, if they're actually serious about doing that, they need to take chances like this, unless they're a completely unserious football team, which is completely possible as well. So that is all. Forrest Lamp, I love Lamp. You should too. All right, so your thoughts, Forrest Lamp, let us know in the comment section below. Subscribe for daily Vikings takes. If you want to support the work, pull some of the Venmo, plus give us a follow on social media as well. But until next time, Skull, production value.